28. Thank you, Delta Papa 7 Delta.
Kilo Uniform 4 America.
Kilo Uniform 4 Alpha 592829.
Roger 5903.
Thank you, QNZ. Oscar Mike 8 Delta Delta. Oscar Mike 8 Delta Delta 592830.
This is a Drake Sea Line, very famous and popular pair called Drake Twins of a transmitter T4XC and receiver R4C, designed to work together to make a very nice amateur station. There were actually a total of four series of these, starting with a T4X and R4A back in the 1960s, mid-1960s. There was then an A model, T4XA and R4A, a B model, and the final version was the C line, R4C and T4XC. These I bought at an estate sale, and it really didn't take much to get them going other than a thorough cleaning of contacts. This has no modifications whatsoever. This is pretty much a stock set of equipment using all the original tubes. There were a number of modifications that were commonly applied to some of this equipment, and that included replacing the tubes with a solid-state plug-in that would essentially make it a solid-state radio, and you didn't have to worry about tubes burning out or the heat associated with the tubes. Frequency coverage on the ham bands here was from 160 meters up to 10. And then with this switch here, you could put in up to 15 different crystals that would allow coverage of other frequencies such as international broadcast bands and so forth. Preselector here, notch filter here, which is very good. Up here you could select from several optional IF filters for narrow CW filtering. Down here you had AGC, could be slow, medium, or fast, and a lot of nice features. The passband tuning here allowed you to select between upper sideband, lower sideband, and then also for radio teletype, you would set it down here. On the transmitter side, there's the ability to select additional crystals. The tube finals, of course, so it requires tune-up. And you could select to have, in this case right now, the receiver VFO is applied to both the receiver and the transmitter, so it's basically simplex on that frequency. You could also select to have the transmitter VFO operate both, or you could do them separate. So this would allow you to transmit on a different frequency than what you received on. So that's the Drake Sea Line. Basically around the mid-70s, in 1973 is when the R4C came out. Very popular, very good performing amateur equipment for back in its day, from the RL Drake Company in Miamisburg, Ohio.